TWA was unique in that it was an airline run by flyers. They all had a passion for it. They knew that there was a future in aviation. They had a dream to know what was beyond those mountains and those clouds and as high as they could go. My name is Ruth Richter Holden. I am privileged to be here because I was born in the beginnings of commercial aviation. My dad was Paul Richter. He was known as Paul E. Richter, Paul Richter Jr. He left the farm in Colorado thinking that there was a future in aviation. Came to the West Coast. He found a man that he liked. His name was Jack Fry. Jack Fry taught him to fly. Jack Fry, Paul Richter, and Walter Hamilton started Aero Corporation of California. They were the first to teach aerial surveying, aerial sightseeing, crop dusting. To form this Aero Corporation of California, these three men had to buy a Jenny. So each one had a Jenny, which is the old World War I aircraft, and $5,000. That was their beginning. This was the beginning of TWA. Paul Richter and Jack Fry and Walt Hamilton were known as the Three Musketeers of Aviation. These three men were together from 1926 until the end of 1946. AeroCorp was a flying school, and they were the first accredited on the West Coast and one of six in the entire country. My dad, Paul Richter, and Bon McDougall, they started the 13 Black Cats. Paul Richter and Jack Fry and Walt Hamilton, they decided that they were able to get a demo that was a six passenger. And so what do three guys do with an airplane but start an airline? That was named Standard Airlines. It was a division of Aero Corporation of California. They flew one airplane three times a week from Los Angeles to Phoenix. And then within just weeks on into Tucson and ultimately El Paso, they connected into Mexico and connected into the Midwest. The first transcontinental flight of TAT, which was flying in the daytime and by train at night. In 1929, Western Air Express bought out Standard. TWA, Trans World Airlines, known to most of you today, was Transcontinental and Western Air, and it was formed by the merger of TAT, Transcontinental Air Transport, and Western Air Express. Now we have Transcontinental and Western Air. There was a tragic accident. Newt Rockne was killed. At that point, It was time we got out of wooden airplanes. Richard Robbins asked Jack Fry, who was his assistant at the time, to write a letter to aircraft companies and give them our specifications and tell them what TWA wanted as a passenger transport. In 1934, TWA started flying all metal airplanes. The first one was a prototype. It was called the DC-1. In 1934, Douglas delivered 12 DC-2s. They went on the line and reduced the flight time from 48 hours to 26 hours. TWA was the first coast-to-coast all by air. You see behind me is a Lockheed 12A. It was built in 1937, and it's part of the reason I'm here. This airplane acquired me about 3 years ago, at which time I found out that I flew in it back in the 40s with my father as the pilot of the plane.